Okay, good evening or good morning, whenever you see this movie. So, this is my peer detector. I will reset it. Everything working fine. Now, I converted the water detection with the pump. Previous video, you might see that I connected this with the relay to pump, and this will draw the water from the half the quarter bucket that I am quarter of a barrel that I am standing on when taking a shower, instead of me pouring the water to the trees from the roof. So what I did here, I turned it. Will later at winter sometimes at the roof, meanwhile I will turn it on, I will put it on half, fill the water, it will alert whenever the water is filled. And now why I need it, because the roof, wherever I live, there is upper roof where all the detector, all the sun barrels are, wherever you get hot water, there is there, and sometimes it's clogged. I will show you when. Just a minute, I will put it to the full and start it. And I want to know whenever there is water clogged. You see, now it's saying there is water, and be careful. The probes I made by myself, they are simple but very, very good. I'm very satisfied with this design. Now it's full. I can turn the water down. It stops. Of course, I can turn off the full one because I use it rarely, and or less than the half, and turn off this device. Now, the water alert will sit somewhere above over there. So sometimes the hose where I point now is clogged with the leaves and with bones of birds. You ask me how come bones comes up there, because there are birds that are predators like falcons and hawks or whatever birds. They come to eat their prey over here and leave the scraps and the leftovers at that roof, and this is clogging the exit of the water, and it becomes full with water and start to drip inside the stairs wherever I live, and make mold, and I don't know that there are water here unless I come up and check. So with this device I can be alerted, and after I position it, of course, and then I will take action. Another thing, before the sun is falling on Tel Aviv, before the dark is coming, now it's twilight, the twilight time, I connected two barrels over here. You see there is difference in the color of the water. I noticed that whenever these two probes, and it matter which is plus and which is minus. The minus, I think, is this one. That's where you can drink, where the butterfly fell. And this is the plus, where the water is dirty. Now, what happens here? Generally, I don't have the LEDs turned on because it's not enough dark. And these probes should tell me whenever there is less, no water. Whenever is no water, I showed you in previous, I get alert over there or buzzes, some buzzes. How it works, that there is a chip with a counter, and whenever it gets from the chip zero ground, this gives him a zero. He can feel water passing from this side to this side. It feels the zero, and it keeps quiet. Whenever there is, this is outside, and you can be sure that it's lighting over there. Whenever there is, you know what? Maybe I will show you again that all my stuff is working. It buzzes. Now it will not. There is a buzz. Just a minute. I need the small chair. That's my chair. And then here, that's a buzzer over here. Maybe we can hear it instead of coming. So whenever the 12 volts, let's see. If you cannot hear, I can hear it. Let's see if the camera can catch it. You see, that's another circuit I made that makes this, I think it's 40 or 80 hertz sound. Not with a conventional buzzer, but something with a diaphragm. This diaphragm is working with some circuit with capacitors and two capacitors and two transistors. All together they produce about 80, I think, I'm not sure, maybe more hertz of sound, and that's what you see, what you hear now. I will put it back so it will shut the noise. So what happens here is whenever it feels zero, it's quiet, and whenever it feels zero, it gets zero from one side and like 9 volts, which I measured here, on the other side. While it gets 9 and 0, it makes dializa. And that's the dializa you see here. It's not a professional one, and I will not drink this water, but for checking, measuring stuff, it's good. Because now I know that I can spread the water, the ions of the water, in a way, and generally, I saw a video in YouTube. If you do it in a sterile way, you can drink the minus water and not the plus. The minus is very alkaline and you can drink it. Okay, that's the scenery of my neighborhood. Okay, thank you for